अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू माय चैनल ऑल अबाउट केमिस्ट्री। होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। आई एम योर टीचर मिस सना। सो दिस ट्यूटोरियल इज अबाउट पीएच स्केल, पीएच मेजरमेंट एंड एसिड बेस इंडिकेटर, एंड दिस लेक्चर इज डिलीवर्ड बाय मिस सुमेरा। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम, लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड।
कोट ऑफ द डे, स्टार्ट टेलिंग योरसेल्फ You can. Objective of today's lesson is students will be able to understand measurement of pH and nature of solutions with the use of different indicators. Chemists use a number scale from 0 to 14 to describe the concentration of hydrogen positive ions in solution. It is known as pH scale. This is figure 10.1 from the page number 34. Scale given from 0 to 14. Look at 7. 7 is neutral solution. If numbers decreasing from 7 to 1, solution will be acidic. If numbers are greater than 7, solution will be basic in nature. pH 7, neutral, less than 7, acidic, greater than 7, basic. How to measure pH? Number 1. pH paper or universal indicator paper, litmus paper and acid base indicators. These three methods are commonly used. Number 1, pH paper or universal indicator paper. pH paper is dipped in a solution. Any solution, unknown, maybe acid or base. You have dipped the solution, it will change its color. Now its color is red. Now this given paper, red color, will be matched with the pH paper. This figure 10.2 pH paper is given in page number 36. Now match the color, this is matched with 1. So this number is less than 7. So we can say solution is acidic in nature. So we can perform in this way to determine nature of different solutions. Now second experiment, we are dipping pH paper in second solution and it turns blue. Now match with pH paper color. This is matching with this color. Number is 11. Now this 7 is greater than, now this 11 is greater than 7. So solution is basic in nature, because pH greater than 7 indicates basic. Come to the litmus paper. Two litmus papers are there, red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. Now look at the colors red and blue. Dip in a solution, red litmus paper. If solution is base, it will turn blue. So we say that basis turns red litmus paper to blue. If red litmus paper dipped in acid solution, there will be no color change. Now blue litmus paper dip in an unknown solution. If it turns red, what will happen? If blue litmus paper turns red, it means it is acidic. If it is base, there will be no color change. Hope you understand the students. Figure 10.3, the soil sample is given. Sample A turns red litmus blue. The soil sample B turns blue litmus red. Which soil is acidic? Can you tell me? Hmm? Can you? Any guesses? Yes, acid will turn red litmus paper to blue. So the red litmus paper sample A turns blue. It is basic. Remember, acid changes blue litmus paper into red, while bases changes red litmus paper into blue. Acid-base indicators are intensely colored organic compounds. They are different chemicals. How they work? We will add few drops of indicator to given aqueous solution of unknown pH. Given solution, we are adding indicator. If color turns pink, so the given indicator is phenolphthalein. What will happen? It will turn pink. Common acid-base indicators on page number 39 with pH ranges and color change. Page number 33, Society, Technology and Science. There are pH ranges given for some plants to grow in good conditions. Apple 5.5 to 7.0, broad beans 6.5 to 7.0, carrots 6.0 to 7.5, onions 6.5 to 7.5, potatoes 5.5 to 6.5, tomatoes 5.5 to 7.0. This is your assignment time. Page number 38, self-assessment exercise 10.4. Write names of three acid-base indicators. You can tell. Yes. Previously, we have discussed and in table it is given. Question number 2. What is the color of methyl red in pH 4 and pH 9? pH 4 means, yes, it is acidic. While pH 9, yes, it is basic. Question number 3. Bromothymol blue added to a solution imparts blue color. What is the pH of solution? pH 5 or pH 9?
Okay, so this is all about today's lecture. Thank you so much from my side. And yeah, don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.